Very good morning, students. How are you all? I hope you all are doing well and started your studies already. Today, in science subject, we are going to start with our 13th lesson, that is changes, which are physical and chemical. Now, changes. What do you mean by changes? Okay, to understand that, first, let us understand the meaning of physical and chemical. When there is a change in the structure and state of the substance that surrounds us, then there are changes caused in surroundings as well. There are physical, chemical, biological changes occurring around us. Some of the changes are natural, while some of the changes are man-made, means that changes are done by us. Okay, now word-to-word meaning for physical and chemical means, when there is a change in only state of the substance, okay, maybe it may be size, it may be shape, then it is called as a physical change. And chemical change means if one form of a substance is transformed, okay, as totally new substance has been formed, then we can say it's a chemical change. Now, as seen on the screen, you can see many pictures have been given. What changes have taken place in the material seen in the following pictures, and what kind of changes are they? In picture 1, we can see that the milk is turned into yogurt, correct? So, conversion of milk to curd or yogurt is a permanent change. It's a permanent change means from curd you cannot obtain milk back. Okay, then it's a chemical change as well. Means one form of a substance is transformed, it's changed into totally new form. So it, we can call it as a chemical as well. And it is a irreversible change. Okay, there are concepts, words we can say reversible and irreversible. Reversible means we can obtain back that original substance, means the things which can occur again and again, reverse way, forward, reverse that way. And irreversible means the once that change takes place, the again original substance cannot be obtained. Second picture, if you see, the ice is melting, forming water. This is a physical change, correct? Means the only state of the substance is being changed over here. Means from water we can obtain ice, again from ice we can obtain water. So this is a physical change, as well as we can call it as reversible change. Okay, reversible. Then in third picture, the seed is sprouting. Okay, so we can categorize or we can call it as a natural change. It's not a man-made change. Okay, it's happened naturally. That's why it's called as a natural change. In picture 4, the water is boiling and we can call it as a physical change. Means that there is a conversion of water to water vapors. Again, from water vapor we can get back the water. Therefore, it's called as the physical change. Fifth picture, if you see, you can see it's a bursting of cracker. In picture 5, the firecrackers are exploding and this is man-made change. It is fast change. You know, whenever you burst the cracker, immediately it burns. So, it's a fast. Then, it's a chemical change as well. Plus, it is irreversible change as well. Now, whenever I will explain you these terms in detail, again we will discuss about these examples. Then you will understand it in a proper way. Next picture, if you see, burning of wood, or a wood is on fire resulting into ashes, and this is a chemical change. And last picture, again it's a firecrackers. So same way, way we explain, that is for fifth picture, it's a man-made change, it's a fast, chemical, irreversible change. So this was just introductory pictures to make you understand the various changes. Lesson number 13, changes physical and chemical, part 2. Let us see the different types of changes in this video. First one that we are going to learn is natural change. The changes that occur naturally are called natural changes. For example, a fruit falling from a tree, rusting of iron, raining, etc. are the changes that takes place naturally. Lightning and electric bulb and cutting vegetable, if you see, that are called as the man-made changes. Some changes are natural changes, some are man-made changes. So the changes which occurs naturally, to them we call it as a natural change. Then the changes that are done by man, okay, for our different, in a many different things we need in our day-to-day life, these things are obtained through different types of processes, and to satisfy these needs the processes are done and various things are manufactured by man. So all those changes comes in a man-made changes. Next change that we are going to learn is useful changes and harmful changes. Useful changes, the changes that produce useful things and help in our needs are called as a useful changes. So for example, cooking food, baking bread, sharpening pencil, or making different items from the papers. So that all changes that are counted as a useful changes means for particular use we are doing that changes. Next to useful changes, the concept comes harmful change. Okay, so the changes that are not useful for us and that causes harm to us are harmful changes. For example, rusting of iron. Different iron articles are used in our house. If they are not oiled regularly or normally in rainy season, if they comes in contact with the moisture, they get rusted. Okay, and what happened? Because of the formation of rust, what is the meaning of rust? You might have seen in rainy season, if iron articles, they comes in contact with the water, okay, so that black colored iron is converted to reddish orangish colored powder. Okay, if you touch the iron article, we can see the powder like structure on that iron articles, that is called as a rust. So rusting of iron, it is a harmful change. Why it's harmful change? Because it reduces the shelf life of iron articles. Second harmful change, we can call it as a spoiling of food. Spoiling of food is also a harmful change because it's not good for our health. So this was all about harmful changes. Next one, next category that we are going to learn is the fast change and slow changes. Okay, obviously as per the name or as the name suggests, fast changes or quick changes are the changes that takes place in a short period of time, or the changes occurring rapidly are called as the fast changes. And example for that is a bursting of crackers. When you burst or when you light up the crackers, you know that cracker burns within a certain seconds. That cracker is converted into sound and light energy. So that is an example of fast changes. Opposite to fast change is a slow changes. What do you mean by slow changes? The changes that takes place over a long period of time are called as a slow changes. Means some changes takes a long time. Again, one example, if you see ripening of fruit, okay, it's not immediately the fruits are formed and to the next minute it turns into the ripened fruit. No, it takes 2-3 days to ripen. Okay, from the growth of the fruit to the ripening of the fruit, it's the long duration, and therefore we can call it as a slow change. So this was till 5th number, what changes we have seen? Natural changes, useful change, harmful change, fast or quick change, and slow changes. In next part, we are going to see or learn some more types of the changes. Okay. Lesson number 13, changes physical and chemical, part 3. Now, let's move on to learn some more types of changes. Sixth type that we are going to see is reversible change. Okay. What do you mean by reversible changes? The changes that occur in a forward and reverse direction repeatedly again and again are reversible changes. Okay. Forward and reverse direction. For example, melting of wax. Okay. Suppose if you take a candle and heat that candle, wax candle, it will be converted to a liquid. And again, when that liquid gets cooled, that is converted to a solid wax or solidified wax. Okay. One more example of that is what? It's a melting of ice. Okay. So that this is very common. Both the examples are very common, which we have observed. When ice is converted to water, and again you can obtain ice from the water. So some such changes are called as reversible changes. Now, irreversible changes, opposite to it is what? The changes that can never occur back in a reverse direction, okay, again, are irreversible. Example, burning of paper to ash. Once you burn the paper, it is converted to a black colored substance, which is called ash. From that ash, we can't get back the paper. Okay, so it's a irreversible change. Okay, conversion of or the ripening of mango. Okay, from raw mango to ripened mango, that change. It's an irreversible change. From the mango, you cannot get the raw mango. Okay, so such type of changes are known as irreversible changes. Next type that we are going to see is periodic changes and non-periodic changes. What is the meaning of the periodic changes? Periodic changes are the changes that occur again and again after definite interval of time. Okay, in reversible, what we said, reverse way it is. Okay, that is from solid to liquid, liquid to solid. That is forward and reverse direction. But in periodic change, changes are occurring again and again after definite time. For example, night falls after a daytime. Okay, means after a night, there is a day. Again after a day, there is a night. So this is called periodic change. After 24 hours, after perfectly 12 hours, night is been over and day starts. Okay, again after 12 hours, day gets in, come to an end and night starts. So this particular time-bound changes, they are called as periodic changes. Non-periodic changes, what comes in this one? There are the changes in which the time interval is not fixed at all. Okay, it can occur anytime. Such changes can called as non-periodic changes. So any type of changes, you can mention it under this category. Now, whenever I am explaining these types of changes, you might have seen that some examples I have repeatedly used. For example, rusting of iron. Okay, rusting of iron, I gave it as a example for natural change. I said it was the chemical change. Again, you can categorize it in under a slow change. Okay, so while classifying the changes, we take into account only one criteria at a time. However, a number of different criteria can be applied to the same change. Okay, means change or that particular object will be same, but you can categorize it into different types of changes. Okay, so for example, for exam if it comes, while classifying changes, we have to take into account only one criteria at a time. means suppose if I write the example rusting of iron, ripening of mango, what type of change it is. So whichever is the correct one, some might write it down, it's a slow change. Some may categorize it as a chemical change. Some may categorize it as a natural change. Okay, so any one change we can write while classifying the changes. Now on the screen you can see the pictures, okay, that from raw mango, ripened mango is been formed. Then secondly, you can just see there is in a dish, there is a mixture of scrap of iron and some different pieces. So with using iron you can separate out the pins. Next picture is the change of the state of the flower, okay, that from the bud there is a formation of flower. And next example you can see there is a change of ice into liquid. So we can just categorize these changes in a different time. Okay, so next change that we are going to learn for this example is physical change. When the substance change from one form into another without the change in basic characteristics, then it's called physical change. Physical change does not form a substance with new properties. Means if ice is converted to a liquid, then its properties are not changed. That properties of the water will not change. So such changes we call them as a physical change. For example, processes of dissolving. Means suppose if you are taking salt and dissolving it in a water, if you are taking sugar, dissolving it in a water, you are changing the state, but you are not changing the properties of that particular substance. Means from the salt solution, we can get back the salt again. So such changes are called as physical change. Then next change comes to a chemical change. To understand the chemical change, let us understand the concepts of corrosion and galvanization as well. That we will discuss in next part. So, after learning the definition of physical change, let us see what do you mean by chemical change. The change in which the properties of the substance changes entirely new substances, okay, and is called chemical change. Or we can say that the change due to which one substance is transformed into another substance having new and different properties is called a chemical change. And for example, a corrosion. Okay, let us understand what do you mean by corrosion or rusting of iron. Corrosion means rusting. Corrosion is caused by oxygen, moisture, vapors of chemicals in the air, and metal shows corroding. Means when an iron article rusts, a reddish brown layer is formed on it. Sometimes a greenish layer is seen to form on a copper article. So this process is called as the corrosion of metals. Okay, and because of corrosion, these metals or these things become weak due to this corrosion. And corrosion, whatever is caused by what? Oxygen, which is present in the air, moisture. So when metal comes in contact with the oxygen and moisture, the oxides are formed. And that oxides are nothing but the corrosion of an articles or metals. Now, iron articles are given a thin coat of zinc. Zinc is the name of metal. Okay, it's a white colored metal, you can call it as a zinc. It's iron articles, means the, if take example of the our pipeline, which is the pipes which are fitted in the bathroom fittings. Okay, to carry the water, whatever bathroom fitting pipes are there, not the stainless steel one. Taps, we are not talking about the taps. We are talking about the pipes which carries the water. So those pipes, they are made up of iron, but they don't look like a black in color. They look like a silver colored, okay, whitish or silver colored. So what is that? It is the coat of zinc metal, and it prevents the corrosion. Okay, so that coating of zinc is called as the galvanization. Copper and brass articles are coated with tin, and this is called as the tinning. Means to stop the corrosion, these metals are coated with. Okay, nowadays you might have knowing that coated pans are available. Okay, that non-stick pans. Actually, what are those non-stick pans? They are also coated. Some layer of the MDF and different layers are given on the metal. Same way, the iron articles, copper articles, brass article, they get corroded, because to prevent this corrosion, these are either they are galvanized or they are tinning or tined. Okay. In this age of technology, a new process which is called as the powder coating. Okay, powder coating is the coat of various colors are applied on metal like iron and aluminum. So they prevent the corrosion of metals. So this powder coating material we have seen nowadays window panes, slide windows which are present in our house. If you see the rim of the corners, frames of these windows, in between there is a glass sheet, and the frames are like white colored, black colored. They are directly, they are not made up of aluminium or this one. In ancient old houses, if you see, that frames are made up of aluminium. But nowadays, the in new construction, if you visit any new house, you can see the frame of the glass windows. They are made up of metal, and there you can see their powder coating. Okay, they have given particular color, sometimes white color, black color, but it is a coat of different colors is been applied, and it is called as the powder coating. So in this lesson we have studied the various type of changes. So from the point of view of the exam, you have to remember the meaning, the different types of changes. Okay, then we should know the different example for those changes, and again based on the differences we should be able to distinguish between different types of changes. So here we come to an end of the lesson number 13, changes physical and chemical. Thank you very much.